welcome to Gord Field here in Detroit Rock City, home of the Motor City Maniacs. Now, I see the Maniac fans are trying to get the fire wave going, but so far just a small number of fires and mostly just on the upper deck.
Yeah, they've really stepped up security, Grim. In the men's room earlier, I only witnessed 3 random assaults and 2 of them were on me. Not bad for gang day.
Both teams hit the field ready to hit each other in this MFL matchup. The Killadelphia Evils go up against the Motor City Maniacs. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say.
Hey, man, nobody can touch me with an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about, Pop?
Hope you got your mutant tailgate buzz on. I know I did. The teams are revving up on the sidelines, and we are ready for some mutant football. Grim Blitzer along with Bricks and Bricks Jr.
Yeah, Grim, I had a little eye-opener myself at the mutant bloodmobile park next to the taco truck outside. Called a lobotomy shot. Raccoon rabies blood and red bullcrap. Hoo-hoo!
Yeah, I can tell your mouth looks like a hot shaving cream dispenser.
And it's 1st and 10. Pow! With the brain scrambler! Second down and a lot. This is your brain, and this is your brain on berserker drugs.
As bad as that guy's brain.
Boom! And like the Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got that mutant bingo. All I need is 77 to bite it.
And it's 1st and 10. That's how you run it, folks. Picks up 8 there. Second down and 2. Oh, a great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. And it's 1st and 10. Well, 1 yard is better than nothing, but not by much. Second down and 9. Maybe the QB should throw it and catch it too. Third down and 9. You've got to catch that. And this field goal is certainly within the kicker's range. He's got the distance, and the kick is good. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh. I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chimp wearing a wig.
And it's 1st and 10. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Down and forever. And they went to the air and came up big. Second down and more than the QB would like. first and 10. Second down and a mile. Well, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole.
Third down and the QB is saying his prayers.
Kill this berserk, dirty, tricky.
Bam! Say goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
Goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
You're an idiot.
The 10. And they're catching up.
Joke, jump, do something.
I don't remember that being an officially sanctioned MFL rule. Had enough with this rep and jumps off sides to kill him. And it's first and 10. Great run for a 9-yard gain. Bring up second and 1. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
And they line up for the extra point. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make him pay. And it's first and 10.
Wrestling?
And it's first and 10. Oh, great tackle! When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely in a convalescent home.
And that'll bring up second and 1. Mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. And that'll bring up third and 1. First down. And it's first and 10. To go down. It's about a 3-yard pickup. Second down and 7. Thank you. a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. And it goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
And it's first and ten. Man, he shuffled his feet so well on that play. He should go to lost wages and deal cards. First down! And we've got a tight battle here as quarter one comes to an end.
Finally.
And it's first and ten. And the ball razors through the defense, cutting a defender in half.
That means they can wrap up the other half and save it for later.
They weren't even on the same page on that play. Second down and ten. Try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
Straight through the uprights. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. First and ten. Oh, he was hitting mid-hurdle and fumbles the ball. And that'll be second down and four. Bring up third down and seven. Now, here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it. Great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right.
Oh, sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Grim.
First down. You know, Bricks, a lot of people have gotten pass happy in this league. Nice to see some old school mano a mano on the turf, huh? And it's first and ten. Oh, the defense must have called a hot potato dirty trick. That'll wake you up and then put you to sleep permanently.
You snooze, you lose.
Unless you're in a sleeping contest.
First and two. six. I'll bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim. But my watch is a bit slow.
Roid rage. Because if you can't answer your question with violence, ask. And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done. Extra point attempt. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. First and 10. And then it's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
And it's first and 10. Second down and 4. You know what they say? Sometimes the best offense is the best offense. Pussy's bricks. They're going for two.
Yeah, they got big balls, Grim.
No one was going to stop him. That's 2 points. In a league full of undead and monsters, humans have a right to strut their stuff.
Yeah, man. I was keeping on the middle now. You know what happened?
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. First and 10. And then catch will give them a first down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good set of hands.
They stump the clock with their first timeout, leaving them with 2 in case they need them.
Yeah, just like condoms, hatchets, and wives, huh, Grim?
You know, you just summed up why we don't get together outside of work, Bricks.
Oh, and that's how you play defense. Of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown, and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick. Down. The QB saves some clock by calling a timeout. They have 1 left. first and 10. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown! Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It's good. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
Goes into their 2-minute drill.
What the hell is that?
It's the same thing as a hurry-up offense, you moron.
I am so...
Maybe the QB should throw it and catch it, too. And the hurry-up offense wears out the defense since they can't rest their players. Quickly call a timeout to stop the clock. Third down and, well, good luck. That was equal parts great run and bad defense. The defense just used their last timeout and there's still plenty of game left to play.
Well, congratulations. You just played yourself.
Memes won't make you cool, Bricks, no matter what your mom says.
And he booted a high arcing rainbow. Nice catch, and he turns on the afterburners. Punt returners in this league have a life.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yawn.
And that's the end of the second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the halftime show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered Frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. The teams line up for the kickoff to start the second half. These guys will have to play a lot harder to make it a game. Well, either that or kill and cheat more. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
And it's first and 10. And he gets 3 yards on that run. Second down and 7. And that's a run for no gain.
Then it's not really a run, is it?
And that'll bring up third down and 7. The way to move the chains, that's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. And it's first and 10. Boom! Second down and six.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
They need to call an attack ref dirty trick and stop this or they're going to lose.
Not like they need any help with that, though, ref. These guys are doing fine by themselves.
Second down and long. And the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. Great catch for a big gain.
But still not enough for a first. Even I'm frustrated, and I'm a team agnostic.
Third down and five. Leaving a wake of destruction in his path. And the offense has only two running backs left, and the defense is licking their lips.
I think they want to hit those last two runners for this action.
And it's first and ten. They run it for a yard. Second down and nine. And he held on to that one for a first down. And it's first and ten. And the QB might have... Oh, man, Bricks, you gotta love a player who goes down fighting.
Hey there, little baby. I'm the greatest. No, you didn't see that.
Second down in a very lot. He broke free and has open field in front of him. And it's first and ten. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. That pass was good for 10 yards. Third down, and the punter is warming up. Well, why go for one when you could go for two?
It's always been my philosophy, but Bricks can't even get one. Oh, you talk.
The offense screwed up that play, Bricks.
I've never had a chance, Grim. Never had a chance.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were gonna tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chick wearing a wig.
And it's first and ten. Oh. broke that one wide open.
Hey, speaking of breaking one wide open, who's sitting on the oil rig about to blow? Hey, smells like an oven-baked port-a-john in here. We're a freaking fracking accident waiting to happen. Don't nobody light a match.
Just keep pounding the ball right up the gut and you'll tire these guys out. First down. And it's first and 10. Second down and more than the QB would like. He runs it for three. Third down and, well, good luck. He dropped it. If he does that again, they'll drop him. Boring, but smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
And he put all of his foot into that one. The return man catches the ball.
Oh, devastating hit.
You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
And it's first and 10. He had it for a second there. Second down and 10. Down and never gonna happen. Oh man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're gonna hit a guy that hard.
4-3 comes to an end, but this game is far from over and will be decided in the final quarter. You know, sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. Booted a high arcing rainbow. He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
And it's first and 10. Second down and a lot.
Goal!
If you ever do that again, Bricks, I'll shoot you in the head.
But people like it!
Little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make him pay. Shave a few days off his life. It's first and 10. First down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. And it's first and 10. First and 10. And that's perfect coverage. Nice deflection. Second down and 10. I'm surprised no one uses the electric carving knife anymore, Brick. They're going for two. And he finds his target for two.
Yo, man, nobody can touch you on eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. He's going to be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
First and 10. Whoa, and he laterals the ball to the player behind him. And the ground game is starting to soften up the defense. First down. And it's first and 10. Nicely done for a first down. First down and 9.
This is welcome to the Groin Rage. How can I help you?
Yep. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sinners.
Straight through the uprights. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
First and 10. I think the defenders are scared of this guy, Bricks, and they have every right to be.
Yeah, he's a murderer!
And it's first and 10.
6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. My parole officer calls. I was with you last night, Bricks.
No problem. I spent the night in lockup for solicitation.
And this guy's running like an old guy looking for a bathroom. First down. And the 2-minute warning sounds. They'll have to regroup during this timeout. And it's first and 10. The ground game should be their bread and butter. A gain of 8 right there.
Hey, anyone seen that Korean kid yet?
The offense calls a timeout. This is why you save your timeouts. So you can use them in the 2-minute warning.
Now I get it. Makes sense, Grin.
The offense wants to speed things up, so it signals a hurry up.
Yeah, same as Prince's ex-girlfriend signaled when they were doing.
Remember, folks, in the MFL, you are allowed to touch the quarterback just like that. Third down and long. They use their second timeout, but they are running out of time.
A bit pessimistic, don't you think so, Grim?
It's more about building tension, Bricks. That's all we do at this point. And drink this bourbon. Come on, give me that.
Oh, sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I know so much.
And that'll be their final timeout. The quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense. He's looking for a quick score.
Aren't we all, Grim? Aren't we all?
That's a killer. It was right there, and then he dropped it.
Oh, scumbag is killing me in fantasy.
And the quarterback signals for a hurry-up offense.
Hey, Grim, what's the hurry-up offense?
There's no huddle. The offense calls plays at the line of scrimmage and 5-yard gain on that pass play.
Hey, look at the coach. He's picking his nose. You know, they shouldn't put that on the Jumbotron. Seems like every time the camera shows him, he's either spitting, picking.
Oh, great play. He is on that receiver like glue.
You know, when I was little, my dad used to make me eat glue. My tongue would get stuck to the roof of my mouth, and I couldn't talk.
Your father was a very smart man, Ricks. Very smart.
And that was a perfect pass, and he scores handily. Man, are these guys greedy or desperate? Either way, they're going for two. The defense comes up big, stopping a 2-point attempt. Looks like they're lined up for an onside kick.
I thought they were going to do some sort of chorus line.
You usually only talk about kickers when they win or lose games. Well, this guy just earned his paycheck.
Which is typically the amount the quarterback tips on dinner.
Changes the pace by going into a hurry-up.
Does that mean the defense gets into a hurry-up, too?
Rip, did I kill him?
No, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peckerhead. Get the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole, up here. Talking to you.
The kick is good.
As expected. Those are pretty much just
looks like they're lined up for an onside kick. And it's first and 10. Huh? to do after this one-point loss.
We've all got some work to do after this one. For example, your enunciation could have been a tad better, Graham. And Junior, you can't swear all the time.
I don't know what the fuck you're fucking talking about, you fucking shithead.
Speaking of shitheads, let's hear the MVP of today's game brag about the win. With Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it so you...